We've looked at stability of this effect across time on a single asset, the EURUSD. We can also go broad by looking for this effect across different assets. This isn't always going to be applicable, but it usually will be. One of those contradictory realities is that not everything will work across all assets, or even across all related assets, but we don't really need it to. There could be a host of reasons why an effect shows up in one place but not in another. But seeing the effect play out more broadly is another tick in the four column of our ledger of evidence. It also means that there's the potential to tap into the benefits of trading an effect broadly, which we've covered in our initiation lessons and falls under our TMS banner. So we're going to look for this effect in different assets. First, here's the long and short plots for EURJPY, not EURJPY, USDJPY, over the period 2009 and 2018. That's the long side. And that's the short side. So we see a very similar seasonal effect in the yen to the one that we did in the euro. Next, let's look at the major currencies crossed against the USD. So to do that, we're going to tell Zorro to load assets from one of the DarwinX assets lists and wrap the seasonality plotting functionality in a loop. See where I've highlighted there the while asset loop thing. Here it is. So we see that broad seasonal momentum reversal effect when we look at these seven pairs in aggregate, which is extremely promising. There's clearly been a very large and persistent effect here, but intraday strategies are very expensive to trade. So are we going to be able to trade this at a retail FX broker? Time to do some backtesting.